We are going to plan our future projects here, and I made this this book here that has the projects in them, like so. And the projects are referring to the map that is shown here. And as you can tell, we have already finished a few of the missions. We have secured Sky Village in episode 9. We have dismantled a graveyard in episode 6. Here are the projects that I have planned for the near future. We are going to raid the dungeon at the Little Tower because I think there's a lot of very great things in there as well. We're going to make peace with the Piglins, you know, the disguised Piglins in the Mushroom House. I'm quite sure that they might just be civilized, actually, if you just treat them right. So I'm going to give them a present and hope that they are going to lay down their arms. Then I'm going to make a little village around the hut with the Fletcher and the Nedved. I'm going to make a new villager that will be a farmer, so we can get a few more villages down there. And then I'm going to make a little farm for the people, maybe from the farm at the mine colonies just next door. And then I'm going to make a few little houses in the redwood trees and in the hillside, just between the villager hut and the base hut. I'm going to make a wall around the empty colony, going from the hunter's hut all around the colony, across the hill to the crater. And by the crater, I'm going to make a fort to protect us from the vampires and try to lure the golem into it, and also maybe the vampire hunters to get them to guard the fort. Then we are going to repair the base hut and make a cellar below. We are going to make a new base just between the hunter's house and the empty colony. There is a great ravine I'm going to show you in a minute. And then we're going to move our base from the base hut to the new base that I'm going to make. So let's just take a look at that new base first. It's just over here. I just made the basic preparations so I can do a lot of the building. I think I'll do it on camera, but probably not make it into episodes until it is somewhat finished, and then we could make a big sort of 0.1 episode about it. So this is the door to the new base. All of this will be excavated, and then we're going to see the ravine here. So all of this empty space here, that'll be base. And look at this. Down here, you've got a mine colony house that I am very hopeful will be integrated in my base somehow. I think I'll maybe make the first colonist live there, and then sort of have them as a part of my staff at the base. But you can see here there's an opening, and I'm going to make the base from this crafting table here extend upwards and downwards, and I'm going to make a staircase down from ground level down to level 0. And I'm going to make a nether portal as some of the highest priority, so we can get on with the brewing and maybe then saving some of the villagers from the Tower of the Deceased, that they then can live in the new village around the Hunter's Hut that will be called Redwood Village. So making a base here with a advanced storage system, and then the staircase down to level 0, and then the nether portal. That is the plans for this space here in the near future. So these are the projects, and I also made a few items from the mods that I'm going to show you now. And of course there will be a lot of other modded items that I will just make along these different episodes here. So let's see some of the new items later on. These guys here will be a part of a assault crew that I'm gonna make to take back the airship. But that's in the future. Now let's see. We got the leaf camouflage armor that I have shown you earlier, and another part of Tough as Nails is the polar set that is used for surviving in cold weather. That looks like this. So here we are. That is for cold weather. And of course, the upper levels of mine colony is actually as code that you need this protection. So I made that for when we are going to make the wall up there. Then I have made a quiver from the, I think it's called Nerf's quiver, that also has an expansion called Nerf's quiver expansion. And we are going to put it on by using this icon here. And that is from Kuios mod. So let's see here. Now Fungian got a quiver on the back. That can be used to store a lot of arrows, actually. So you can see here, he got a lot of inventory. And I think it's only fair that he carries a quiver, considering that he has this this bow with infinity on. There's also a lot of different arrows you can make, because I have a mod on called Extra Arrows. But that'll be in the future as well. I'm going to produce a lot of different arrows. Okay, I made another purified water canteen, as you can see here, just because I don't think one is enough. Then there is this thing here. This is a tool belt that is made with a mod called Tool Belt. Let's see here, Tool Belt. Here it is. And here's the crafting recipe for it. It goes like this. And then you have pouches. And these are also from Tool Belt mod, and they're made like so. Now, to get the pouches on the tool belt, you have to use an anvil, and that'll take levels, which I find very reasonable. Like this. And I'm out of levels. So you put the tool belt on through this couriers. To see it properly, you have to take off the armor. Now you can see the belt and equip it like so. Three slots for inventory in the belt itself, and then I put two extra pouches on. I'm going to put in the spyglass, as I am using the zoom function from Optifine, and that's sort of cheesy, unless of course you have the spyglass, which I have here. Then I'm going to take a water bottle as well, and get some levels for getting the extra pouch on. Now, then we got this thing here. This is a extended deconstruction workbench. It is used for deconstructing things, and you put in a disc that you make like this. Then you put it on the floor, and you start deconstructing things. We could try, for instance, deconstructing our, let's see, our pickaxe here. So you put in a pickaxe, and then it tells you what it will deconstruct it into. The disc here, of course, has usage, as we can see. And now you start, and you end up having these things over here. So now we can actually deconstruct things that we don't really need. Let's see what happens if you deconstruct a book. That will give us actually all of the parts that was in it. Now I find this very actually both fun and also quite quite fair actually. As I really like to recycle things both in real life and also in the game here, especially with all these modded items, it might just be very handy for us and also quite exciting actually, especially if you can do this with the modded items. Let's see. What? Recipe is not opened yet. Oh, that makes sense. Let's see what's it saying. Recipe is not open yet. Try to figure out how it's made. Now that is great. So I can't just do it with anything. I can't just recycle everything. I have to actually find out what it's made by. So now we have a little project we have postponed for all too long, and that is getting the bed back to the vampire hunters. Now I feel terrible that I have been you know, neglecting this as I promised them actually. But of course, it's just recently that somebody actually moved into this place. But take a look. I think we have a vampire hunter living here now, and the other guys should move in as well soon. This is of course to protect them from all the bad guys. And the bed should be, I think, maybe by the window, so they can actually look out and see if there's any problems. So that's it, and of course the mushrooms grows in here. That's quite fun. I think that just keep doing that then. Yeah, So that was the bet for the Vampire Hunter. Now, I hope the other ones are actually also going in here. Oh yeah, there's two in there now. Oh, that's great. So, they can get through the fence. And they'll stay in there and be safe till we need them in later game. So, that was the... Oh, while we're here. Oh, I... Yeah, let's go. I'm going to make a little trip up to a grave I found. And of course, it's easiest to spot them at night. And when we get there, I need my pickaxe to excavate it. Now, these sort of XP orb-like features, they are just ambient graphic. So, they don't really mean anything. Yep. And there are, of course, bees up here. Which is great. We're going to do a lot with them later on as well. Because I got a mod on here that actually has a dimension for the bees. Okay, so we need our pickaxe out here. Let's see, so like so, yeah. And we're going to get the cup. Wonder what's in here. Yeah, but as I said, there's double grave. Oh, and we got our first enchanted book. Thorns 1. And we got two name tags. That seems fair, as we lost two trying to get the llamas to not despawn, which of course failed. And now, having our first enchanted book. That's great, because I actually been planning on using one of the other mods I got on. That is called Enchanting Runes, I think. And it's a really nice early game mod. It makes it possible for you to enchant stone tools. So it sounds a bit overpowered, but it really is quite actually balanced, because you can make enchantments level 1 quite easily actually, but it is only on stone tools. That means that of course they will actually get spent quite easily, and you will also, of course, with things like sharpness and so on, actually not get that much sort of maximum enchantment power because of the stone quality. But I like that very much as a sort of early game improvement to help us with all these quite hard, actually, circumstances we got in this game. Now, enchanting runes, you start by making a very special tool that we're going to use to make the runes. Two gravel and a stick makes you a rune mason's blade. Let's go down in the basement here that I'm starting on to cut some stone. You simply take your knife and then you just cut stone like this in order to get blank runes. Yep, you got the point. So, let's see. These blank runes, you can then sort of change into different kinds. You can take flowers, like this, and put them in crafting grid, and then surround them like this. Then you get the Ack rune. And, similar fashion, you can smoke runes to get an rune. You can surround them with clay to get a yuck rune, surround them with bread to get a third rune, and cook them on a campfire to get the ist rune. Now, the idea is then that you take the runes you need to make a certain enchantment, and then you enchant your stone tool. We go to enchantment table. Oh yeah, we need blank runes for the rest, and we got that plenty. So, we take the item, and we take the runes in the right order. And then it should be a matter of... You see, here we spell it Yuk-Ak-Yuk. That doesn't really sound right. Yuk-Ak-Yuk. That's probably not it. But hey, then, if we don't spell anything that is on the list, then you get a random enchantment. So let's try this. Doing... It finishes in one. It was actually the right one. Okay, so I tried to spell efficiency one with the runes from the list in the mod description, and then I actually worked. That is the enchantment runes mod. I think it's really well balanced because you can make enchantments early in the game, but only on stone tools. It does not cost you levels, but it costs you, of course. These materials. There are other runes that demand snow, for instance, and kelp. These I don't have at the moment, so I can't show them. Yeah. So that is the enchanting runes mod.